Welcome to the complete user's guide for the STB-6000 set-top box. Now in this video we're going to go over the most important functions of the device and we'll look at how to get it set up for first time use, along with going through the menu options and choosing the best options for your particular setup. We'll also look at doing a firmware update on the device, where we will download the firmware update from the Laser website. We'll also install that firmware onto the device itself, and we'll also look at the recording functions, how to do a manual record, how to do EPG recordings, and also how to play back those recordings on the device itself or on a computer. And finally, we'll look at the media playback capabilities of the device and how to navigate the Laser website to get the most out of the product. Okay, so you can stay up to date with any questions and answers that might pop up on the website, along with any new firmware updates. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so when you first turn on your STB-6000, you should be greeted with an installation guide screen. So just select your options there and then go to channel search and press OK. Now the device will start searching for all the available channels. You'll see a progress indicator at the bottom there. Okay, now with the channel search, you need to make sure you've obviously got an RF antenna cable plugged into the back of the set-top box. Now this antenna cable really needs to be something that's connected to the roof of your premises, so the indoor bunny ears style aerials won't work. Okay, so we'll just let this progress bar finish. I'm just gonna pause the video and we'll skip ahead to the part where it's pretty much done, and then we'll continue from there. Okay, so once the device has finished recording all the channels, it should start just playing back the content or one of the channels. So as you can see here, okay, so after you've done all this, set up all the channels, we want to go through the menu and have a look at some popular options that, you know, are good for you. Okay, don't mind the really dark picture there. I've just set the exposure very low because I was getting a little bit of glare from the office here. So let's just press the menu button. Okay, so we've got a couple of little options here. I won't go through these. I'll skip to the important stuff. So picture is very important, so we'll have a look at this. So the aspect ratio really determines the shape of your TV. So if you've got one of the old square sort of shaped TVs, you want 4x3. And if you've got a newer widescreen TV, you want 16x9. Okay, it's probably best to set it to auto if you're not sure. Okay, now with the resolution, this is very important. So if you're using the red, white, and yellow AV cables, the maximum resolution you can really get with that is about 480i. Okay, so leave it at that. If you're using HDMI, the resolution will really depend on what your TV can handle. Now most newer TVs can do full 1080p, so you can set it to that. It's best to find out what your TV can do. Okay, so I'm just going to set mine to 1080p. Okay, there we go. So TV format, now back in the old days you had to select between PAL and NTSC. So the difference there is 50Hz versus 60Hz. You obviously want the best, so faster refresh rate means less flicker. Okay, so when you set it to PAL or NTSC, you'll have the option to change from 1080p 60 or 1080p 50. So most newer TVs can do all. So just set it to NTSC and leave it at 1080p 60 for the best picture quality. Okay, so on-screen display, this just affects the transparency of your menus. Okay, so the exact screen that we're looking at here. So next we've got just the setting up of the channels. Don't need to do that, we've already done that. Now this one is how to set up the time. Obviously you want to select your region and then select daylight savings.
Okay, so if you turn this to manual, you can manually select your time zone. Okay, so just leave it at auto. Okay, the sleep function just turns the device off after a set amount of time, very self-explanatory. And the info about timeout, that's when the little, every time you change the channel, a little box comes up showing you the information at the bottom. So this will affect that, how long that stays up for. Okay. Now let's look at options, on-screen display, subtitle language, subtitle type. Okay, so this one here, digital audio. So this is very important. If you're using like sound bars and AV receivers and things, this can be different depending on the way you've set it up. So with the newer HD channels like 9HD, 7HD, etc., there's an option where RAW, PCM, or off. Okay, so the difference between RAW and PCM is RAW will send a uncoded signal straight to your receiver, soundbar, or similar device. So most soundbars, they don't have a decoder installed inside it. So sending a RAW signal to a soundbar really means that you're probably not going to get a sound out of some digital channels like 9HD, 10HD, because it's just sending a RAW signal and the device isn't able to process that RAW signal. Therefore, no sound's coming out because nothing's being processed. So really, for the most ideal setup, you want to have it set to PCM. PCM means that the device itself, which is the set-top box here, does all the processing of the sound and then outputs it to your speakers, whether that be your soundbar, your TV speakers, or through your AV receiver. Now, most people with an AV receiver will probably benefit from putting it to RAW, because that means it's the AV receiver is doing all the decoding, which it's capable of doing, or most of them should be. So, you know, you get better quality uncompressed sound that way. Okay, so, and obviously because your receiver will have a better sound chip than the set-top box itself. So, you know, if you really know what you're doing, yeah, set it to RAW. And another word for RAW is actually bitstream. So use that function if you know what you're doing, but leave it on PCM for everyone else. So if you find that some channels you're not getting sound, especially the HD channels, ABC HD, 7HD, 10HD, all those, if you find that you're not getting sound and you're using HDMI, this is the setting that you need to go to. So come here, set it to PCM, and you should be good to go. Now finally, the last option, or last tab here, is system. Now, parental guidance, set password, and factory reset all have the same default password, which is 6 zeros. So press the zero number on the remote 6 times. For example, if I select factory reset, it'll come up with a password screen. So you need to press the zero button here 6 times. Okay, I won't do that. But if you're having any trouble with the device, a factory reset is actually very good. Okay, so the information will, in the software update, we'll go over that in the firmware update video. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the menu, and it's the general setup. Okay, here I'll be showing you how to do a firmware update on your STB-6000 device. Okay, so first of all, you want to go to our website, the laser website, which is this part there. So www.laserco.com.au, and that'll take you to this page here. Just from here, you want to search for the device. So just type it in here, and you'll see all your accessories, spare parts you can purchase, and there's the device itself. Okay, so on here you have a few options. Obviously you can purchase the accessories, you can have a look at the features, learn a bit more about it, specifications, some other videos that we've done on the device, our download section, which is what we'll be focusing on, is our firmware update and the manual, and our Q&A section. So it's important to go through this website and look at all of these things. So there's a lot of Q&As here. You know, just tells you how to do some basic things on the device. So have a read through them. There's 2 pages worth. Okay, so for the purpose of this clip, we'll show you the firmware update. So just click on that. Now you should see the file start downloading, as you can see down here. Now this will save into whatever download folder you have selected on your computer. So I'm doing this on the Windows-based computer. So now that's finished, I open my folder, and for me it goes into a folder called Downloads. Okay, so as you can see, that's that there. Now the file that you download is a zip file. What that means is it's a compressed file with more files inside it. So instead of getting you to download 4 or 5 different files, we have you download one file, and the files that you need are inside. So once you've downloaded this file, you can right click it and select Extract. If you've got a program called Zip, 7-Zip or WinZip, you can also use that, but the default Windows 10 should have it, this Extract All feature, so just select that. Now it'll just say, this is the folder it'll be extracting to, so just select Extract, and that's done. So now we've got a real folder, and we've got our files in there. So have a read through the instructions, the firmware update instructions. It tells you what the patch notes are, so what we've fixed in each version. So with this latest one, it's fixes an issue with stuttering recording. Okay, so there's the instructions on how to do it. So very simple, literally take this file, copy it, grab a USB stick, yeah, something like that, plug it into your computer. Okay, you should see the drive appear, as it just did for me. Okay, so now that I've copied the file, just paste, and that's it. Now the file's on my USB stick, and we'll continue the firmware update at the actual set-top box itself. Okay guys, here we are at the device itself. Now we're just going to plug the USB stick into the front USB port. You should see a message pop up, USB device is inserted. Okay, just press the menu button on your remote. Okay, and then just go over to the system tab, and then go down to software update. Now just select USB upgrade, and then the file that you copied earlier. So just press OK on each of these screens. And you should see a screen pop up showing you the progress. Now just wait for that to complete. The device will reset once it's finished updating. Okay, so that's reset now, and we just want to press the menu button again. Go back over to system. Now to check that the firmware update was successful, just go to information, and you should see your SW version, which is software version number, which is version 2.1. So that's exactly the firmware update that we just did. So as you can see, that's successful. Okay, so that's the firmware update complete. Okay, I'm just going to go over some of the recording functions on the STB-6000. Okay, so with the recording, you will need to use a USB drive or a USB stick. So with the USB stick, or the drive, it needs to be no larger than 750 gig, and it needs to be formatted to the FAT32 or the NTFS file system. Now you would normally do that formatting on a computer, preferably a Windows-based computer. Okay, so once you've got a USB drive or stick ready, just plug it into the port, a USB port on the front of your STB-6000. Okay, and now we'll go over some of the recording functions. There's a couple of ways to record. There's the first, most simplest way of doing it, and that's pressing the record button on the remote, which is this one on the bottom here. Okay, so the bottom left-hand corner of your remote. Simply just press the record button, you'll get this message come up, and then a progress indicator in the top left-hand corner indicating it's recording. That indicator will stay there while it's recording. Okay, now while it's recording, you're not actually able to change channels outside of this network. So at the moment we're watching programs on the ABC network. You are able to change channels within this network itself, but you won't be able to change outside of that network. So for example, ABC Kids, ABC News, yeah, you can change between all of those. The device will still keep recording the original channel that you selected, okay, but you will be able to flick between the different channels within that network. So if you wanted to watch channel 7 or channel 9, for example, you wouldn't be able to do that while this device is recording using the single recording method. If you want to know how to record two channels at the same time, please watch our other video, which tells you how to set that up. Okay, now I'll just demonstrate changing channels. See, ABC Comedy Kids, ABC, ABC HD, and then if I want to go past HD, it won't let me, okay, because the next channel is a non-ABC channel. Okay, so we'll go back to the, okay, see in the top left hand corner you can see it's channel 23 that's recording. Okay, so we'll go back to channel 23 and we'll just press the stop button. Okay, so the stop button is this button on your remote there, indicated with the white square, which is the universal symbol for stop. Okay, so just press OK now to select stop recording. Okay, now that's stopped. Now the other way of recording is using the EPG function. So again, just press the EPG button on your remote, which is this button here, just down from the down from the directional pad. Sorry for the low light, guys, I'm just getting a lot of reflections and glare on the screen, so I had to turn all the lights off here. Okay, so with the EPG function, press that button, you'll get this screen come up. Okay, so some important information here. The top right hand corner, you can see Wednesday, 6th March 2019, 11:25. That's very important because that's the current time of your device. Okay, so left and right on the remote, we'll swap between the different channels. Okay, and up and down, we'll go between the different programs on that channel. So as you can see, the top one will be the current program, and the one just below that will be the next program, and so on. Okay, so we can see the time is now 11:25. Let's see if I can find a program that starts soon, so I can demonstrate the EPG recording. So I think we'll go back to 11:28. That one looks good enough. Okay, so press OK to select the program. And you'll see some information come up here. Now you can change the start and end time if you like. Okay, but the most important thing here is the mode. You want to change that from view to record. If you leave it on view, when the time has elapsed for the program to start, it will only change the set-top box to that channel. It won't actually record it. So make sure you've set it to record so that it actually changes that channel and then also starts recording. So we want to select record and then just press the OK button on the remote, and now you'll see that that program has been booked into the schedule list. So I'll just press exit to get out of this, get out of the EPG menu and go back to the TV stations. Okay, so now we can, if you want to check which programs you've booked in for recording, you want to press the blue button on your remote, which is the one in the bottom right hand corner where it says timer. Okay, so if you press that, you can see your EPG schedule. Okay, so that's the one we booked in a bit earlier. Okay, so I just press exit. And what's the time now? 11:27. So we've still got a couple of minutes before the program is about to start. Okay. Oh no, it looks like it's starting now. Okay, so you'll get this message come up on the screen. Booked event time up. Okay to record. Exit to cancel. Just don't press anything. Okay. Just wait for this. Okay, so it's obviously just started recording there, as you can see with the progress indicator in the top left-hand corner. Okay, so now that's recording. So that's your EPG function, guys. Now again, if you want to stop recording, same as the manual recording, just press the stop button on your remote and you'll get this message come up. If you don't want to stop recording and you've pressed the stop button, just press exit on your remote to cancel that, so it'll keep recording. Okay, so we're gonna stop the recording now, just so I can show you one more thing. Okay, so okay to stop, and that's stopped. So now we can look at playing back your recordings. Okay, so the way you want to play back your recordings is with the list button on the remote. So that's this button that I've got my finger on. Can see that? No, can't see it. Okay, and anyways, it's the button, the third button underneath the power button on the top right hand corner. Okay, just look for the one that says list. So when I press the list button, you'll get a screen here with all your shows that you've recorded. Okay, so you can just scroll through that, and the files are recorded in MTS file name. Okay, I'll talk about that a bit later in playing back these files. If you want to play them back on a computer or something, you'll really need to have a program that can play MTS files. So I think VLC is one of the programs you can have on your computer that can play them back, but you can't rename any of the files. Okay, so make sure if you copy this file onto your computer, and you know, you put the USB stick on your computer, you rename the files, and then you put it back onto this device and try and play it, it won't work on this device, the renamed file, because our device has a very specific naming convention for the files, so you won't be able to rename files if you want to play them back on the set-top box 6000. So to watch one of these shows, we can just either press the OK button on the show that we want to watch. Okay, now you'll see that that program has just started playing in a window on the right hand side. Not really ideal, unless you know you obviously just want to preview the video. Okay, but to play it back in full screen, you want to press the play button. Okay, so go to another program there and then just press the play button. So the play button is the one just above the record button, the manual record button that you used earlier, which is in the bottom left. See, so if you just press the play button, you can watch the videos back in full screen. Okay. And obviously just to stop playback, just press the stop button. Okay, so that's pretty much it. That's all the recording functions and the playback functions. If you want to access the recorded shows another way, instead of pressing the list button, press the menu button, okay, and go over to USB, and then media player, and then you'll see PVR, personal video recorder. So select OK on that. Select your USB drive, and there's your programs there. Okay. Okay, that's it for the recording function, guys. Okay, here we are at the computer, and I'm just going to show you how to play back recorded TV shows from the STB-6000 on your actual computer. So just open your File Explorer, type program, Okay. Obviously, plug your USB stick that you've recorded your shows onto into the computer. So for mine, it would be this drive here, test. And then open this HB PVR folder. Now you can see the files all here. You want to open the file at the top there, which is not the meta file. Okay, so as you can see here, you can see the size of the file. You can configure these tabs as you want, but for mine, you can see here the file size. So 6 kilobytes is a very small file. There's obviously no video content there. Okay, so this is the file. Now, as you can see, this little icon, the color and the icon style looks to be like a Windows Media Player. Now, if I try and open this file with Windows Media Player, okay, you can see there's no video there. You can hear the sound. Okay, but there's no video. So that is because this MTS file name is not compatible with Windows Media Player. So Windows Media Player doesn't have codecs or the correct language to support this file. Okay, so I really recommend you use a program like VLC if you want to play these sort of files back. So in my case, I've already got VLC installed, so I would right click the file and I can go to open with, and over here I've got all the different programs I've got installed that can play back movie files. So when I select VLC Media Player and just wait for that to open. Okay, so you can see now the sound and video is playing. It's because VLC has the correct codec to support playback of this file. So very important, guys, if you're trying to watch your recorded shows on your TV, on your computer. Now another thing is, as I explained in the recording video, do not rename these files if you ever wish to play them back on your set-top box. Okay. After you've recorded them on your set-top box and you're copying them to your computer, but you never want to watch it on your set-top box again, you're happy to watch them on the computer alone, yeah, you can go ahead and rename them to your heart's content. You don't even need to keep these meta files. You can, in fact, delete that, and the file will still play without any problems. Okay. But if you delete that meta file or you rename this file, you won't be able to play this file back on the set-top box. Okay, and that concludes the playback of the recordings on your computer. Okay, just going to quickly show you the media playback capabilities of the STB-6000. So after you've copied your files to the USB stick or the USB drive, just insert it into the USB port on the front there. Okay, now press the menu button and go to the option on the far right, or you can just go left once. Okay, so now we've got the media player. Now in the media player, you can, as I explained before, you can watch your recorded content under PVR. You can watch movies, photos, and music. Now with the movies, they need to be an AVI or DivX container and codec, and the resolution of the file can be no larger than 640 x 480. So just make sure you're adhering to these specifications, because the file won't work, or you might find that the audio works and the video doesn't. Okay, so definitely need to have those specifications on your files. Now with the music, you can play MP3, WMV files, and photos will read JPEG, MPEG, and PNG. Okay, so let's just go to the music section. And as you can see, there's a couple of files there. Literally just select the file that you want and press OK on the remote. And it should start playing. I think I'll just turn the volume up so you guys can... Okay, so as you can see, that's working. just press the stop button to stop, or you can use the normal skip back and forth. Let's just try that out. Okay, so skip forward, we'll go to the next track. If you're at the end of the list, skip forward won't do anything. Okay, so skipping back will go back to previous file. Okay, so stop button on the remote to stop. Now, let's go back one screen. Press the exit button to go back one screen. And let's go over to photos. Now, as you can see, there's a couple of files there. Okay. So again, pretty simple. Just select the file that you want and press the OK button to bring it up. Okay, so I've just pressed the OK button, it's loading in. And there you have it. So that's the photo mode. And finally, the video section. I'll just demonstrate the movies. Okay, so as you can see, there's an AVI file there, 640 x 480 resolution. So pay attention to that number because you'll need to adhere to that resolution. If you're not sure of what the resolution is, while you've got the file on your computer, you can right-click it, go to Properties, and then the Details tab. Under the Details, you'll see the resolution, the height and the width of the actual movie. And you want that 640 by 480. Okay, so just press OK to have a small screen preview. Okay. Let me just turn that down. Okay, so just like with playing back videos from your PBR, OK button does a small screen preview, and the play button will be a full screen. Okay, so let me just press stop, and then press the play button. So as you can see, the video is now playing in full screen after pressing the play button. Okay, that's the media player function done, guys. Thank you.
Okay, so that concludes our video for the user's guide of the STB-6000. If you've got any other questions that weren't covered in this video, please drop us an email at support@laserco.com.au and we'll reply to you as soon as possible. Thank you.